गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक थ्योरी ऑफ कंप्यूटेशंस। दिस सब्जेक्ट इज इन थर्ड ईयर फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर। विल सी व्हाट आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट प्रायर टू लर्निंग द सब्जेक्ट। एज द नेम स्पेसिफाइज दैट थ्योरी ऑफ कंप्यूटेशंस, इट इम्प्लाइज दैट whatever the computations a system perform, we have to learn the machine, the techniques which are working in order to perform these computations. Okay, is my screen visible? So this course contains total 5 units. It is only theoretical subject. No practical implementation is available for this subject. These 5 units have to be discussed all the concepts of computations through various types of machines. So what are the various types of machines? We will see one by one. Each unit is being assigned a maximum teaching duration of 6 hours. So maximum teaching load for this subject is 30 hours. Okay, so we'll see what are the contents that we will study in this course of theory of computation. Okay, remember one thing, this is only a theoretical subject. There is no practical implementation for this subject. Okay, it is also based on that 60-40 pattern, which we are very much well aware of. Okay, so totally as discussed that there are total 5 units. So in first unit we will study about finite automata. See, automata is nothing but the automation system. Suppose whenever we need to perform any operation, we will give an input to a system. The system will process that input and it will produce the corresponding output. Human task is only of giving the input and collecting the output. The actual process which is being performed by the system is independent of human activity. So this type of machine which is independent of process, which is independent of human activity in processing, is an automated machine. Example, today whenever we have visited several shops, in that shop, if we drop a 5 rupee coin, we can fill 1 liter of mineral water bottle. This is an example of an automated machine. We have to just drop in a 5 rupee coin, and that 5 rupee coin, when the system receives as an input, it will give you 1 liter of water. Okay, so this is an example of an automated machine, automation system. Another which is very well known and popular example is the ATM machine. Okay, so you know that in an ATM machine, whenever the user swipe his card, at that time what happened, he has to just give the input credential, what is the total number of amount he requires to withdraw. Once he withdraws the amount, enter the amount, the machine will withdraw him the exact same amount which he has mentioned. Okay, so this is about the automated system. So finite automata means the system which is working on a finite data system. Okay, means the input to the systems are finite. Matlab input kya dena hai ye pata hona chahiye. System is only running successfully when it knows what are the possible sets of input it has to process. If we give a data as an input which is not recognized by the system, then that type of data will not be processed. Example, if you try to give an while fetching a mineral water of 1 liter, if the system require input of 5 rupee dollar, and if you are trying to enter 1 rupee dollar, it will not recognize that. It needs a 5 rupee dollar itself. Okay, so this is an automated system. Here we will discuss two types of automation systems. Okay, first one is the deterministic and another one is the non-deterministic. As the name specifies, that deterministic means the input is known, output will be calculated, and output will also be determined after calculation. So it is determined and it is finite. Means system knows what are the possible inputs, what are the possible output it can produce. So everything is determined, so it is deterministic. Non-deterministic systems are an infinite number of sequence processing system. It is an infinite, it can process infinite data since it includes one character entry as epsilon. Epsilon is nothing but it is also capable of processing the null input, void input. Okay, we will see one by one when we'll discuss in detail what is deterministic and non-deterministic. Suppose I have given you a task. Whenever we are given some task, suppose the task is to check whether the number which is entered is ABC. The number which is entered is A, B, and C. Suppose if I am to check this, so what are the possible matches that we have to perform in order to match A? Total there are 26 characters. In order to match A among 26 characters is 1 by 26. In order to match B out of 26 candidates, alphabets is 1 by 26. In order to match C out of 26 alphabets is 1 by 26. Okay. So if you want to match a string ABC, first we will try to match A, then we will try to match B, and then we will try to match C. Example, when you are entering a PIN in an ATM system, whenever you are entering a PIN in an ATM system, suppose my PIN is 1101. What will happen if I enter the incorrect PIN? The system will not withdraw me any cash, or it will not perform any operation which I want to perform on it. So how the verification of the string will be done? Suppose my string is 1101 is my PIN. So first it will verify whether I have entered first one as one. Means if that one is matched, then it will continue to match the second character. If suppose my PIN is 1101 and I have entered at 0111, at that time what will happen? The system will not let me in, and it will not even check the second character itself because I have entered the first character wrong. Okay. So in this type, what will happen is it will not perform the remaining computation. But if my PIN is 1101, if I entered 1100, it will perform three matching 110. And since I have entered the fourth character as wrong, so it will again not let me in. But it will perform matching of three characters. Okay. So this is an example of a deterministic machine. Okay. And most probable examples are ATM machines, fetching a 1 liter mineral water from a machine. So these are the real-time example where we use this automation nowadays. But these are only dependent on five tuples, which I will explain you in the upcoming lectures. Okay. Next is Moore and Mille machine. What is Moore machine? What is Mille machine? Suppose certain after performing some task, a machine should perform the computation as well as it should produce me some output. When we require a machine to produce me some output, then there are two types of model available for this system. The first one is the Moore model and another one is the Mille model. Okay. So these two models are the types of model in which we want a system to take an input from the user and respond with an output. Okay, so whatever is the output the user wants from the machine will be get in Moore and Miller machine. Okay, then we will see what is regular expression, what is a string, what is an alphabet. bit, what is the regular expression, what are the types of regular expression, what is the recursive regular definition, regular definition kya cheez hai, we will see one by one. Okay, and see, in deterministic everything is determined, in non-deterministic we can have an epsilon move also. So here see, we have an NFA with epsilon moves. These epsilon moves are null moves, means if for some condition input is not specified what the input should be at a particular state, so these moves are epsilon moves. So what the system will do in such type of cases, it will enter into non-deterministic finite automation state. How to overcome from this? There is one technique. We'll see how to interconvert between NFA to DFA. See, the type of system which is stable is deterministic finite automata, because we want a system which will take input, which will take all the input, and which will produce a finite state of known output. So the need of the hour is deterministic finite automata. Suppose if we example for this is, suppose if you enter any looping statement, and that looping statement is in an infinite loop circle, we are unable to stop that loop, because we have entered something condition such that which is a non-finite condition. So that is a simple example for non-deterministic finite automata. Okay, so in this we will study mainly, there are three main topics in unit number one. First is deterministic automata, non-deterministic, Moore machine, Mille machine, and regular expression. Okay, in next unit number two, based on the basis of this automation, we will study the context free grammar. What is the context free grammar, how it is useful, what are the production rule, how to write a production, what is the rule for making a grammar, okay, what is ambiguous grammar, how to remove an ambiguity from a grammar, Chomsky hierarchy kya cheez hai, we will study all these things one by one. Chomsky hierarchy produces four levels of grammar. Okay, so we'll see what are the four levels when we will see all these things in detail. So unit number two is only about the context free grammar, how to create a production rule, how to check ambiguous grammar, how to remove an ambiguous grammar, what is derivation tree, what is syntax tree, what is parse tree, how to simplify a grammar, and so on. So unit number two is very, very simple. When we are concerned with unit number three, it is divided into only two parts. First one is the left linear grammar, right linear grammar, and their interconversion. And second one is the CNF and GNF part. Okay, only there are two parts. First one is the left linear grammar, right linear grammar, and its interconversion. And second part is the CNF format and GNF form. See, these all things may appear to be new to you, but once when we will see all these things in detail, you will understand that what all these things are. So it is nothing to panic ki ha ye kya hai CNF, kya hai GNF, kya hai. Once we started teaching and learning on these topics, we will definitely come to know what is CNF, what is GNF. Remember, up till now you were studying the concepts which were at different end of the computer. Now this subject includes some concepts such that it will tell you how actually the computation is performed in the back end, and what are the machines and what are the techniques which we are used to actually perform the computation in the back end of the system. See, by the term back end, I am not mentioning that I am storing data or I am retrieving a data or it is a DBMS type. No, it is not that. I am talking about the computation backend. Suppose if I design a C program, if I give 1 plus 2, print A equals to 1, B equals to 2, C equals to A plus B, and print C, it will definitely return me an answer as 3. But how we get that 3? The computations are being performed at backend, and those computations are being performed by some machines, and that machines we will discuss in area of computation. Okay. Now I think so. I have made it very simple for you to understand. Unit number 4 is a pushdown automata. What is a PDA? What is a deterministic pushdown automata? What is non-deterministic pushdown automata? And what is the power of this pushdown automata? In order to learn this, or in order to study this, again we will shift to unit number 1. And again, that is deterministic finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata. Here you have to thoroughly learn the concepts of DFA and NDFA. This is deterministic finite automata, DFA. This is non-deterministic finite automata, NFA or NDFA. Okay, so the concept which you will learn in unit number 1 will also be implemented in unit number 4, but with a slight change in that. And that is, here it is pushdown automata. In unit number 1, we are discussing automation of finite state machine, FSM. Unit 1 is the concept of finite state machine. Unit 4 is the concept of pushdown automata. And in the last, we will study about Turing machine, the concept of Turing machine. Where do we apply this Turing machine? What are the powers of Turing machine? Why Turing machine is used for performing maximum calculation? Where we use Turing machine, where we use PDM, and where we use FSM. So there are 3 types of machine which we will study. In unit number 1, we will study FSM. Unit number 4, we will study PDA, push down stack memory machine, push down automata. And unit number 5, we will study about Turing machine. So Turing machine are the most powerful machines among the 3 machines which are available. So we will use Turing machine as an industry implementation for performing any of the given tasks. Again, here we have to understand what are the basics of Turing machine, how Turing machine works, what are the various variants of Turing machine, in how many variants we can apply Turing machine, in how many variants we can extend a Turing machine to perform many functionalities. Then what are random Turing machine, what are deterministic Turing machine, non-deterministic Turing machine. See, again the concept come as deterministic and non-deterministic. So unit number 1 is the base of finite or theory of computation, which you have to definitely study thoroughly in order to understand all the 5 units. So deterministic finite automata and non-deterministic finite automata, these are the base of theory of computations, which you have understood that it will be implemented in all the 5 units. Okay, so it is very important to learn all those concepts. What is the Church's hypothesis? This is one type of theorem where we will propose a statement and then we will write a proof in order to prove that the statement which is being proposed is correct. So there are some hypotheses and we'll study these hypotheses. Again, the Church hypothesis, Rice theorem, there are many hypotheses and all we'll see one by one. The next topic is the universal Turing machine, where we can apply Turing machine on a universal domain. Okay, and see, after applying a Turing machine to perform a task universally, these machines have capable of reading multiple inputs of the data at the same time. These machines are having a large amount of memory associated with them. They can perform multiple read write operation at the same time. But there are some problems when a system is reading and performing such multiple operations. Suppose if it reads multiple data, there are some cases where the machine never halts. So that's why you can see the last topic which I have written here is the halting problem of Turing machine. Okay, the halting problem of Turing machine, there are many 3 cases where we take out a Turing machine from this halting situation. Means whenever the machine is not performing as per our expectation, it is not halting, we'll apply some cases and we'll try to stop the machine, halt the machine so that it processes the output as per our needs. So this is the halting problem of Turing machine. There are three cases in that. We will discuss one by one. So this is the total 5 minutes which you have to study. If you count the total number of concepts, I think so, there are only 15 concepts in theory of computation which have to be understood. Total maximum 15 concepts have to be learned in this theory of computation. 15. So each unit there are one or two concepts, and all the 5 units will comprise of 15 concepts which you have to study. Okay. So let's have a look at the reference textbook prescribed by the university for this. But I suggest you to recommend you and suggest you to use only these textbooks which I have written on the screen. Okay. It's my recommendation that you, every one of you, should have the first two textbooks with you. Okay. If you want to make a screenshot, you can take a screenshot of this. You can take a photo of this. This first and second textbook is a must you should have with you. Everyone should have with them. Okay. Theory of Computer Science by K.L.P. Mishra. In this first textbook, you will come to know the basics of unit number 1 and 2 and 3. Unit number 1 and 2 will be covered. Unit number 2, 3, 4 will be covered into 2, 3, 4 and 5 will be covered in unit textbook number 2 by Vivek Kulkarni. Okay. The same textbook is also available in Oxford publication, Theory of Computation by Vivek Kulkarni, Oxford Press publication. That textbook will also do. Okay. So this is the suggested reference textbook which you have to take into consideration for studying this subject. Okay. So when we consider about the university curriculum, okay, so this is about the university curriculum, total 5 units as per our specification, each unit having 6 hours. Okay, reference textbook and textbook are everything is being mentioned. Okay. So I think so, I am done with all the introduction of theory of computer science. Okay, theory of computer science or theory of computation or formal language and automata theory, these are the different names given to this subject, but for our it is theory of computation. Okay, theory of computation. Okay, now anyone want to ask any doubt? Anyone want to ask any doubt? Yes.